Hi, today teardown of this radiomagnetic indicator. So I do not know exactly how to use it, but it is obviously the main compass instrument in an aircraft in order to know which way you are going. We have on this front dial off flag that flips out of the way when the instrument is powered. We have a background disc with compass directions. We have two arrows and two buttons. So you can see we have a green arrow, a green button, a yellow arrow, yellow button. And each of these buttons can be selected between VOR and ADF indications. There is another little flipping arrow here inside. So I guess one of the arrows is indicating the way you should go, and the other one is indicating the way you are actually going, and the goal is to have both of them superposed, but I am not completely sure about this. Okay, there is a backlight built in here in the instrument. Behind this this plate, in fact, is a little PCB strip with little bulbs soldered on it. Okay, so this was for the front side. You can see the four attachment points. They are just holes for putting screws in it. Back side, we have the main connector. Round military type of connector with a modification label here showing it received 5 modifications. These are the screws to attach the aluminium cover, some quality control or something stamp here. Now we can zoom on the manufacturer label. So as you can see, it is given for a 26 volts power supply, 400 cycles. I believe it is the power supply you need for the synchro transmitters and resolvers inside, because there is no built-in power converter in this thing. Made by Aeronetics, a division of AAR Corporation in Elk Group Village, Illinois, USA. There is a huge model number here, 3117L6, no, B, 63C, serial number 2036, on the right here. Okay, now I will unscrew the cover and we will have a look inside. So usually the way these instruments are made, we have a back section with electronics. We have a middle section with motors, synchro transmitters, synchro resolvers, feedback potentiometers and such. And we have a front section near the dial with purely mechanics. So will it be this? Will it be full of electronics or not? Let's find out. So here is what we have. As you can see, the electronics side of thing is quite disappointing. We have not much in this, just one PCB and a few components. But there is quite a lot of things in this middle section and in the front mechanical part too. So, where to start? This PCB back here. We have very simple components, a few op amps, MC1458, another one here in a metal can, then regular passive parts, and a few transistors also. Here there is this metal piece. It looks like we have a bunch of power transistors bolted to it. There is a card edge connector here allowing easy replacement of a PCB, but oddly enough, you can see this PCB is not conformal coated. Quite interesting. In the middle here, we have a few capacitors and resistors on Teflon standoffs. In the inside also, but it is not easy to see. And there is some unpopulated spots here. In the middle, we have a lot of synchro units. We have one here. This one is for the green arrow. A very nice one made by Clifton. This is the switch for the two buttons in the front. And you can see we have one here made by Fujison. And we have another one here which is not the same model. And also the heat shrink is not the same. Here we have clear heat shrinks. And here we have black ones. So maybe it was replaced at some point. What else? So here another synchro something. Receiver probably. Made by Scott Incorporated. And two others here. If there are synchro transmitters, you can see we have dual gears here. This does not turn, oddly enough. We have, and it is all for this part. Another one here also. This one is for the background compass dial. Worcester. It seems it is written, so maybe this one is made in Great Britain. Not completely sure. And here in the front we have all the mechanics moving everything in the front part of the instrument. This black cylinder here is a little motor to actuate the off flag. I did try to power it, but it not. I have only a 15 volts power supply and it is not enough. Also for the backlight. We can see we have more standoffs here for terminals. Nice brass gears in here with stainless shaft, it seems. Steel shaft at least. But here we have a plastic gear. Quite interesting. Why did they put a plastic gear in here? You can see the front piece is quite thick and it is bolted to the faceplate of the instrument. So I will show you the moving parts. So here I am turning this needle, this arrow. This does nothing, it is locked in place. Here I am moving the other arrow. In fact, you have a dual setup in back in here. So this turn and this turn independently. And the last thing, where is it again? Yes, here we have what moves the background of the display. So, it is the kind of instrument I think, not sure if it is, it seems you may have it in a leisure aircraft, in fact. It does not seem to be airliner grade and not military grade. Well, not sure, but this kind of design of instruments with no dust fastener or anything, usually they are for laser aircraft, light aircraft. Not completely sure. Okay, so this one was a little disappointing for the electronics. I was expecting to find more electronics inside, but you cannot know in advance what you will get. But at least just for these pieces here. New these pieces are worth several hundred of euros each. So it is probably already a good deal, as I got it with two other instruments, including the big Deca computer, which I am going to start the teardown right now. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.